the one who cares, he knows.
We lift our hands and bow our knees to worship at your throne. We need you, Lord. We need you, Lord, right now.
We will have one more time for all the voices lift up, say,
we need you, Lord. We need you, Lord. We need you, Lord, right now.
We need you, Lord.
To join us tonight. We're going to go to the throne of grace tonight and obtain mercy from God and just love on him, because the Lord is good and his mercy endureth forever. Father, we want to bless you and magnify your holy name. We want to give you all the praise, oh God, that is due unto you. You are a good Father. You are wonderful. You are loving. You are a God of peace. And Father, we say thank you. Thank you for this day. Thank you for waking us up this morning. Thank you, Lord, that we are clothed in our right minds. I pray, God, for the people who are watching tonight, that, God, you will rest upon them, oh God. Pour out your spirit upon them, God. I pray, Lord, that your peace will be with them tonight, God. Father, I pray, Jesus, that as they open their mouth and bless you, that the heavens will open up and pour out a blessing upon them, oh God. I pray, Jesus, that you will comfort them in this time, oh God. Hallelujah. I pray they will lift their heads unto the hills, God, that they will seek ye first the kingdom of God and his righteousness, so everything can be added unto them, oh God. I pray that you will cover and protect them, oh Lord, that even though the pandemic is here, that they will remember the name of the Lord. For the name of the Lord is a strong tower. The righteous run in and they are safe. I pray, God, they remember that the prayer of faith will heal the sick. That, God, without faith, it's impossible to please you. So I pray, God, that they will have strong faith tonight, God, that they will believe your word, for your promises are yea and amen. You said you came that we may have life in that more abundantly. And so I thank you for the abundance, oh God, resting on them. I thank you for being a delivering God, for being a savior, for being a healer, for being a restorer. Touch them in their mind, oh God. Give them the mind of Christ. Let them think as you do. Let them see as you do. Let them see that they are more for us than against us, and that the greater is in them than they that is in the world. God, I thank you now. I thank you for the word that will be going forth. I thank you for the rich word, the rhema word, the word that will penetrate our hearts tonight, God, the word that will transform and renew a right spirit in us. We thank you for your word, for it is spirit and it is life. For in the beginning was the word, and the word was God. And we thank you that you are still here, inhabiting the praises of your people, oh God. Be thou glorified, oh God, even in the midst of darkness. Let us be the light, oh God, that others can see your good works. We thank you, Lord, for anointing the man of God. We thank you for giving him the word, oh God, to bring peace and hope. We thank you, Lord, for his family. We thank you, Lord, that you are a keeper. We thank you that your love, oh God, covers them. We thank you also for the leadership of this house. I thank you that they are continually praying and seeking after you, oh God. I pray that you will strengthen them, oh God. Give them wings like eagles. Let them soar, oh God, high. I thank you, Lord, that you are keeping them, oh God. That, Father, they're delivering a word that will bring forth life, oh God. For we believe in the harvest that is coming. We are still seeing the harvest that is coming. We can still speak to those dry bones, God, and bring flesh upon it, Lord. Because the power that is in us can manifest, oh God, life. And so we thank you for breath. We thank you for life. We thank you for holiness. We thank you, Lord, for renewing us. We thank you, Lord, for loving us. We thank you, Lord, that we know you, that we are your children. We thank you for being joint heirs, God. We thank you that we can speak those things that are not as though they were and see the manifestation. So we declare, God, healing. We declare, God, healing over this nation. We declare, God, that even those who are mourning, that gladness is coming unto them, Lord. Give them joy. Give them happiness. Let them see, God, that joy is coming in the morning. And so we bless you now, oh God, and thank you. Thank you for what you are doing. Thank you for what you've already done. And we're still looking forward, oh God, to what you're about to do. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen. Amen.
Amen. Praise the Lord again. I'm delighted to give to you an opportunity to participate in giving. Amen. I said an opportunity because this is indeed an opportunity. Today, amen, this school, we're running a campaign called Giving Tuesday. And I realized when I gave my gift, I was thanking God that I had to give. And I felt blessed that I had to give. And then it dawned on me, as long as I have to give and I give, I'll always keep on having. So it's a blessing. So every opportunity that's afforded me to give, I want to give. Number one, because I have. And number two, because in giving, it guarantees that something is going to come back to me. Never see giving as somebody taking from you. I'm a firm believer, and I want you to adopt this principle too. Nothing leaves heaven until something leaves your hand. So even in this season, amen, give. Hallelujah. Let God lay on your heart a gift. Just don't give out of your abundance. Give based on the heart that God has impressed you to give. There are some folks that have been sowing seeds, amen, some making tremendous sacrifices, and it pulls on the anointing to ask God to prove himself faithful to them. I challenge you tonight, give, amen, not what you want to give. Ask God, what should I give out of what you have given to me? Because to whom much is given, much is required. God bless you. Father, we bless every gift and every giver. We believe that you, the God of heaven, will prosper us. Therefore, we, your servants, will continually arise and build. In Jesus' name, amen. Go to the website. They direct you to give. You can give by text, or you can mail in your gift. Whatever way you choose, give. And the Lord will keep giving to you. Good measure, pressed down, shaken together, and running over, shall men come and give into your bosoms. We love you, and thank you for your response in giving tonight. Amen. And praise the Lord again, everyone. I'm so excited to be in your homes one more time to bring to you a word from the Lord. I'm excited, amen, just to be alive, as I said, Sunday, one more day. Today was another beautiful day. We got a chance just for a few minutes to go out in the sun, got some vitamin D, amen. Somebody came by the house yesterday. I won't call the person's name. And they said, Bishop, you're getting too light, amen. You need to get out of the house and get in the sun. So I did that today. The person's initial starts with a D and ends with a W, amen. I won't say anything more. And it's a female, by the way, amen. It's one of the elders' connections. But I got some sun today. I probably get some more tomorrow. And you too should go out and get some sun. Run around your house, amen. Get some exercise and get your praise on, amen. Praise God, hallelujah. I've been singing this old hymn all day today. It is mine, mine, blessed be his name. Amen. God's abiding peace is in my heart today. Yes, I feel it now. Yes, I feel it now. He has taken all my doubts and fears away, though I cannot tell you how. It is mine, mine, blessed be his name. Praise the word God. He has given me perfect peace to me. It's mine, mine, blessed be his name. I'm praying today. I'm trusting today that you have that perfect peace and you can claim it to be yours. You can't tell how God is doing it, but you know he's doing something. Amen. Let's go to God in prayer before we go to the word of the Lord today. Father, we thank you one more time again for your call and we thank you for your anointing. We pray now for your will to be done, for your kingdom to come around the world, wherever the gospel is being preached and your name is being declared. Let your kingdom come. And let your will be done. Let your glory rest upon us now and those that will hear us. In Jesus' name, amen. Praise God. I'm going to the book of Joshua. Joshua chapter 1 this time. And I'm picking up two verses, amen, from Joshua chapter 1, verses 7 and 8. Let's go to the word of the Lord. Joshua 1, verses 7 and 8. Only be thou strong and very courageous, that thou mayest observe to do according to all the law which Moses my servant commanded thee. Turn not from it to the right hand or to the left, that thou mayest prosper whithersoever thou goest. Verse 8, this book of the law shall not depart out of thy mouth, but thou shalt meditate therein day and night, that thou mayest observe to do according to all that is written therein. For then thou shalt make thy way prosperous, and thou shalt have good success. I found in the passage these verses, particularly in verse 8, amen, some principles that I want to lift for your thought tonight. And I want to present to you three principles, amen, that can allow you to prosper even in a pandemic. Three principles that can cause you and I to prosper even in a pandemic. Amen. Praise the Lord God. So we can clearly see from Joshua 1 verse 8 that God is going to prosper his people and cause them to have good success as long as they understand that seasons doesn't change his plan and seasons doesn't alter his promises and the decision that he has made concerning us. It doesn't matter what time you're in, no matter what circumstances you face, what God says overrides those situations. And I feel led of the Holy Ghost to remind the saints tonight in this study that the pandemic is not going to alter your prosperity and cause you not to have good success. Let me say it again. This pandemic, amen, is not going to stop you from prospering. And it's not going to cause you not to have good success. How do I know that? Because I found three principles, amen, in the text that I want to bring to you today. Amen. The First Peter chapter 4, verses 12 and 13, and I'm reading from the Message Bible, says, friends, when life gets really difficult, don't jump to the conclusion that God isn't on the job. Instead, be glad that in the very thick of what you're experiencing, Christ is in it. This is a spiritual refining process with glory just around the corner. Listen to what Peter says again from the Message Bible. Friends, when life gets really difficult, don't jump to the conclusion that God isn't on the job. Instead, be glad that you're in the thick of what Christ is experiencing. This is a spiritual defining process with glory just around the corner. Even in this difficult time, Christ is in this with us, and glory is around the corner. Hallelujah. We all know Romans 8:27. Amen. All things work together for good. But let me read to you from the Message Bible, amen, that text. Praise God. I'm starting from verse 27. He knows us far better than we know ourselves. He knows our pregnant condition and keeps us present before God. Verse 28 from the Message Bible says, that's why we can be so sure that every detail in our lives of love for God is worked into something good. That's why we can be sure that every detail in our lives that we live in love of God is working for our good. God is going to make sure even in this season, you and I, if we apply the principles we're about to discover, we are going to have prosperity, and yes, we are going to enjoy good success. Jeremiah chimes in and he says, "For I know the thoughts that I think toward you, said the Lord, thoughts of peace and not of evil, to give you an expected end." And the expected end that we have discovered in Joshua 1 is that God is going to prosper you wherever you go. Hallelujah. And he's going to cause you to enjoy good success. Let this season of confinement be turned into a season of refinement. Don't feel confined. Use this as an opportunity for God to refine you, to bring out the best that's inside of you. Let this season of stagnation be turned into a season of success. Hallelujah. This can be your best season for growth and prosperity. Oh, I feel God all up in this thing. This can be your best season for prosperity and to enjoy good success. So let's see what the word of the Lord says. Verse 8, Joshua chapter 1. Only be thou strong and very courageous, that thou mayest observe to do all the law which Moses, my servant, commanded thee, and turn not from the right hand nor from the left, that thou mayest prosper whithersoever thou goest. We are told by Joshua here in the text, no matter what's going on, you need to be strong. You need to have with you, amen, the ability to go through whatever we are going through right now and not crack in the gap. Amen. Be strong. And the Bible says we should be also very courageous. Courageous there means be alert physically. Have your foot on the ground. And it means to be alert mentally. Make sure that your mind, amen, is stayed on the Lord. And that the enemy doesn't cause you to be going to and fro. So be strong and be very courageous. Hallelujah. Look now at verse 8. This book of the law shall not depart out of thy mouth. Thou shalt meditate therein day and night, that thou mayest observe to do according to all that is written therein. For then shalt thou make thy way prosperous, and thou shalt have good success. I found, and I want to share with you, the first principle. Number one, we need to master our mouth. Hallelujah. We need to master our mouth. We need to make sure that we are controlling our speech and the words that come out of our mouth. This book of the law shall not depart out of thy mouth. This book of the law shall not depart out of thy mouth. If you want to experience the prosperity that God promises, if you want to enjoy good success that God guarantees for his children, we need to apply this principle. Do not let the book, the law of this book, depart out of your mouth. Master your mouth. Bring your mouth under control. Watch your words and realize that your words create your world. They say you have what you are, what you eat. I like to say also, you get what you speak. If you don't like what's happening right now in your life, I want to suggest to you that you change the way that you're speaking and start mastering your words. Hallelujah. Your mouth shall be used and should be used as an instrument of life and not death. Proverbs says, amen, death and life is in the power of the tongue, and they that love it shall eat the fruit thereof. Whatever you're experiencing in life, it's directly related to the words that you are speaking. Solomon said, if you are careful about what you say, you will keep yourself out of trouble. Listen, Proverbs 21, 23. Whoso keepeth his mouth and his tongue, keepeth his soul from trouble. Hallelujah. If you master your mouth, if you control the words that come out of your mouth, you can produce life. Amen. The word says in Matthew, we are justified or we are condemned by the words that we speak. Let's read it. Matthew chapter 12, verse 36. But I say unto you that every idle word that men shall speak, they shall give account thereof in the day of judgment. For by thy words thou shalt be justified, and by thy words thou shalt be condemned. Again, for emphasis, if you don't like what's happening in your life, the first principle is master your mouth. Watch what you say. Put a guard, amen, over the words that come out of your mouth. Contemplate what you're speaking. Speak life. Speak prosperity. Speak success. And whatever you say, the Bible says you are going to have it. Jesus tells us our words originate and it comes from our hearts. Listen, Matthew 12. Out of the abundance of the heart, the mouth speaketh. A good man, out of the good treasure of his heart, bringeth forth good things. And an evil man, out of the evil treasure, bringeth forth evil things. Therefore, we can conclude, if we're going to master our mouth and our speech, we have to be deliberate about what we put into our hearts. If out of our hearts, amen, the mouth speak, and we need to master our mouth, then we need to be aware and conscious about what we're putting in our heart. And whatever we put in our hearts is what's going to come out of our mouths. Whatever you put into your hearts is what's going to come out of your mouths. Psalm 119, verse 11. Thy word have I hid in my heart that I might not sin against thee. What goes in is what's going to come out. What you put in the software is the program that's going to produce what you want. So be careful then what you put in your heart. And my suggestion is put the word of God in your heart. Because when you harmonize and you are in agreement with what God says, when you speak, you put his word in and you speak his word, you're going to have exactly what you say. And God has to produce for you, not so because you said something, but because you said his word, and he has to honor his word. Praise God. Negative speaking hinders God's desires to bring his word to pass in our lives. God is under no obligation to allow anything to happen in our lives if what is coming out of our mouth, hence coming from our heart, is not his word. He only watches to perform his word. So hide his word in your heart. So when you open your mouth and you speak, you will speak what God says, and then God will have to do exactly what he said. Amen. Malachi chapter 3. Look at this with me. Malachi chapter 3, verse 13 and 14. Your words have been stout against me, said the Lord. Yet you say, what have we spoken so much against thee? The Bible is saying that God says, you have been contrary. You have been speaking stuff that's making me weary. Look, verse 17. You have wearied me, says the Lord, with your words. Yet you say, wherein have we wearied you? When you say, everyone that doeth evil is good in the sight of the Lord, and he delighteth in them. Or where is God's judgment? When you do not say what God says, when your speech contradicts the laws of God, when your speech contradicts the principles of God and the precepts of God. You weary God. But when your speech, hallelujah, agrees with God, you delight God, you please God, and you cause him to act on your behalf and bring to pass whatever he said. Amen. So if you want to experience prosperity and good success, the first principle is master your mouth. Hallelujah. Watch what you say. Make sure you're saying what God says. And the only way you can do that, you got to put that word in your heart so that when you open your mouth, what's in your heart, the word of God, is what comes out. You are literally words away from your harvest. If you just change your speech, if you just master your mouth, everything in your life can begin to change right now. Amen. Do you believe the words that you're speaking? If you do, then you'll have what you say. If you're careful, amen, and in faith choose your words and believe what you say, you will obtain quick results. I believe it with all my heart. Mark chapter 11 says, Jesus answering said unto them, have faith in God. For verily I say unto you, that whosoever shall say unto this mountain, be thou removed, and be thou cast into the sea, and shall not doubt in his heart, but shall believe that those things which he said shall come to pass, he shall have whatsoever he saith. Therefore I say unto you, whatsoever things you desire, when you pray, believe that you have received them, and you shall have them. You've got to believe, amen, the word that you hid in your heart, the word of God, that when you open your mouth and you speak it, God is going to respond and perform it. He's not a man that he should lie, nor the son of man that he should repent. He's obligated to perform his word, but he needs you to bring it out of your mouth from a heart, amen, that believes that he's going to do what he says. So then we can conclude that prosperity and good success, if the people of God obey what Joshua 1:8 says, success, amen, good success and prosperity can be yours. Number one, master your mouth. Watch what you say. The second principle that we can find in the word is, amen, mastering your mind, your thoughts. But thou shalt meditate therein day and night. Amen. If we keep that word, amen, and do not let it depart out of our mouth, the second thing that Joshua 1 verse 8 says, we should meditate in it day and night. We should master our mind, our thoughts. When you master your mouth by watching your speak, what you speak, the next thing you do is master your mind. Hallelujah. Tell your mind you're not going to run wild and think about every and everything. You're only going to think about what God says. You're going to bring your mind under control and tell it, you just can't run wild. You are now going to be disciplined to not think about your circumstances, not be consumed with the situations around you, but your mind and your thought is going to be all about what God says. Your future is not what others predict. That's not what you're going to think about. You're going to think about a future that God decreed and that God declared. There is enough things in the Word of God for us to fill our minds with and for us to think about. Prosperity and good success belongs to those, one, who will master their mouth, watch their speech. Number two, that will master their minds, watch their thoughts. Amen. We have to bring it under control. We constantly have to remind ourselves that we have the mind of Christ. Tap yourself and say, I have the mind of Christ. I have the mind of Christ. And although we have this mind of Christ, we live in this world. That's why the Apostle Paul wrote to us in Romans chapter 12, and he says, I beseech you, therefore, brethren, by the mercies of God, that you present your bodies a living sacrifice, holy and acceptable unto God, which is your reasonable service. Watch now. And be not conformed to this world, but be transformed by the renewing of your mind. In other words, I know everything is going on around you, and if you're not careful, everybody else will affect the way you think. But you constantly have to bring your mind back. I hear what you say, but I am thinking about what God says. And I'm going to make sure what the thoughts of God pushes out the thoughts of men, the thoughts of the circumstances, the reality that I'm living in. And it bring me back to what God declared and decreed concerning me. We have to be constantly adjusting our thoughts about our situations and not allow the enemy, all this world, all ourselves, amen, to make our own determination, conclusions, opinion, judgment about our circumstances. Let me break it down. It doesn't matter what's going on. Yes, I'm hurting, but amen, I can't concentrate and think about the hurt. I've got to open my mouth and I've got to say, by his stripes, I am healed. I'm feeling weak and the pressure is on, but I've got to open my mouth and think about, amen, what God says concerning my weakness. When I'm weak, then am I made strong. My God, we are perfected in his weakness. And if perfection and strength doesn't come, I've got to pick up what Paul says, amen. It's his grace is sufficient for me, and God will not give me more than I'm able to bear. It's amazing when you begin to flood your mind with the thoughts of God and the judgments of God and the declarations of God and the decrees of God, how it gives you hope in the midst of your storm, how it gives you hope in the midst of your trial, how it gives you hope when everything else is going well. I'm not just teaching a lesson. I'm trying to share with you a life experience. Do not let the enemy make you sit down, amen, and concentrate and think about all you're going through. And you've got to say, this is my reality, but I've got some hope in the word of God. And I'm going to flood my mind with that word so hope can push back all the depression and all the situations that's trying to bog me down. We've got to remind ourselves our prosperity and good success is wrapped up in, number one, we mastering our mouth. Amen. Not allowing the word of God to depart out of our mouths. Secondly, mastering our mind, what our thoughts are, meditating on those words day and night. Philippians chapter 4, verse 8. Amen. It's probably an apostolic verse that we all can count, quote. But I want to read to you the Message Bible. Amen. The King James says, finally, my brethren, whatsoever things are true, whatsoever things are honest, whatsoever things are just, whatsoever things are pure, whatsoever things are lovely, whatsoever things are of good report, if there be any virtue, if there be any praise, think on these things. But listen to the Message Bible. It says, summing it all up, friends, I say you'll do best by filling your minds and meditating on things that are true, things that are noble, reputable things, authentic things, compelling and gracious things, the best and not the worst, the beautiful and not the ugly, things that are praiseworthy and not things that are summed up as a curse. So we've got to decide, amen, as we meditate on the word of God, that we do not allow the enemy to push us into the negative realm, but we remain in the positive realm. The negative is not false. It's true. But we've got to focus not on what's true only, but focus on what's truth. Hallelujah. There's a big difference between what's true and what's truth. The truth is, amen, that I've got a need. But the truth is, my God has already supplied all of my needs according to his riches in glory. The truth is, I'm in this body. But the truth is, amen, in my body is the Spirit of Almighty God. I'm trying to tell somebody, don't just think about what's true. Think about what's truth. And he is truth. Amen. He is the way and he is the life. Amen. Wherefore, my brothers and sisters, says Peter, gird up the loins of your minds. Be sober and hope to the end. Touch your mind and slap it and says, you're not wandering. Amen. You're going to be under control and think about what God said about your situation. Think about what God says about you. Let me remind you, as I remind myself, what Paul said in 1 Corinthians chapter 2 and verse 16. For who had known the mind of the Lord that he may instruct him? Who had known the mind of the Lord that he may instruct him? Who knows the mind of God that they can direct God? Who knows the mind of God that they can appeal to God based on what he's already thinking about? Who knows the mind of God? Who has the mind of God? And Paul didn't allow you nor I to answer the question. He answered it himself. He says, we have the mind of Christ. Let me say it again. Paul said, we have the mind of Christ. And I'm up here to tell you tonight that you have the mind of Christ. So therefore, let the thoughts of Christ flood your hearts because you have the mind of Christ. Let this mind be in you, which is also in Christ Jesus. Put, amen, the mind of Christ in your mind and let his thoughts operate. And I guarantee you, because Christ had a particular mindset, a particular thinking, it affected his action, and the results that he got, amen, is what you're going to get if you operate in the mind of God. What happened because he had this mind? The Bible says, wherefore God had highly exalted him and has given him a name that's above every other name. Because he had a mind, amen, that's unique and particular. I won't go into the details, but because he had that mind, he got a certain result. And I'm telling you, good success and prosperity is going to be yours if you master your mind, your thoughts, and you think the thoughts of Christ, and to think whatever he said about you, the enemy can't stop you. Your circumstances will not be the final verdict on your situation because the mind and the thoughts of Christ will produce good success and prosperity for you. Thou will keep thee in perfect peace, whose mind is stayed on thee, says the prophet Isaiah. So I'm up here tonight. I stopped by the teachers by the class to tell the saints there are three easy principles that guarantees to you prosperity and good success. Number one, master your mouth. Watch what you say. Be careful of your speech. Number two, master your mind. What you think about. Think like God. Flood your mind with his thoughts, his words concerning you, the world, and the situation. And the third point, amen, is that you need to master your methods. Master your methods. The Bible says that thou mayest observe to do according to all that is written therein. So you are mastering your actions, your methods. What you do is directly related to what you think about and what you say. Your speech and your thoughts produce your actions. Oh my. So if you want to change the way you're acting, don't try to change the action. You've got to go for the thinking. And you've got to go for whatever has been placed in your heart, my God. And whatever you're saying, because what you're saying and what you're thinking about is directly related to what you will be doing. So, number three, master your methods. Master your actions. Joshua is trying to tell us, control your speech. Control your thoughts and it will determine your actions. You'll end, if you keep your speech be what God said, if your thoughts constantly about what God has said and is flooding your mind with, amen, you are going to do actions that are pleasing to Almighty God. It is impossible for you to be speaking the word of God and for you to be thinking the thoughts of Christ and act contrary to your speech and your thoughts. However, if your speech is not, amen, what God is saying, and your thoughts is not what God is thinking, then your actions will be contrary to God. So I don't want to tell you, sit down to counsel you to change your action, your behavior, because I'll be wasting my time. If I want to change your actions, if I want to change my actions, if you want to change your actions, change your speech. And change your thinking. Your actions will be automatic. Hallelujah. Try it and see if it doesn't work. For as a man thinketh in his heart, so is he. That's what Solomon said. Proverbs 23:7. Your thoughts become who you are. And how you act is exactly based on your speech and your thoughts. Our actions are directly related to speech and thoughts. I love Matthew 15 and verse 19. Amen. For out of the heart proceedeth evil thoughts, murders, adulteries, fornications, thefts, false witness, blasphemies. Listen. Out of the heart, whatever you put in the heart, hallelujah, determines what you're going to be thinking. And whatever you're thinking determines what you're going to act. You can't solve fornication. You can't stop theft and blasphemies if you don't go to the root and change whatever's in the heart by taking up that stuff and putting the word of God in it. And so that word can now begin to dominate the thinking, hence dominate the actions. Jesus was saying, don't waste your time. Amen. Don't try to wash up and clean up. Amen, and think you're going to be perfected by dressing the outside. No, you got to go into the heart because the actions comes from the heart. The thoughts comes from the heart. And God cannot prosper you, amen, and bring to pass what he said about you if you are not saying what he said and if you are not thinking what he's thinking. But the Bible makes us to understand very clearly tonight, God can bring us even in this pandemic, even this climate where people are dying, when economies are collapsing and businesses are failing, even in this situation, if we, the people of God, will begin to let that word be in our mouth and not depart from us, and if we begin to meditate on it day and night, and if we allow actions, amen, to come from of the word and from our thoughts, God says, I'll give you good success and I'll prosper you in all of your ways. The climate, the condition does not change what God says. And if we would put those principles, three principles in place, I guarantee you all of this is going to turn for your good. Master your mouth. Watch what you say. Master your mind, watch what you think, and master your methods, watch how you act. God promises, amen, you have good success. If you want to change your action, change your speech, and change your thinking. Without a transformation of the mind, which is driven by our thoughts and speech, we'll not be able to change our actions. Be transformed by the renewing of your mind. So that you can prove, amen, you can determine what is the will, amen, of God. So you can act accordingly. You cannot control your actions until you control your thoughts. Anybody can give you an opinion about you, yourselves. Anybody can have an opinion about you. But your actions really tell who you really are. Great thoughts alone do not make great men. But great thoughts with corresponding actions makes great men. Prosperity, Amen. Good success can be yours, even in this pandemic, if you apply the three principles. Number one, master your mouth. Watch what you say. Watch your speech. Say what God says. Number two, master your mind. Think the thoughts of Christ. Amen. Remind yourself you have the mind of Christ. Think like Him. Number three, master your methods. Amen. Your actions. And make sure your action comes from your thoughts and they come from your speech. I trust you were blessed by this word tonight. And I pray that you will apply these principles. Master in the mouth. Master in the mind. And master in your methods so that you can have good success and prosperity. I decree and declare prosperity and good success over your life, over your family, over your business, over everything pertaining to you, even in this pandemic. God bless you. See you on Sunday. In Jesus' name, amen.